ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ. ಗುರುರ್ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಗುರುರ್ವಿಷ್ಣು ಗುರುರ್ದೇವೋ ಮಹೇಶ್ವರ ಗುರು ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಪರಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ತಸ್ಮೈ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರವೇ ನಮಃ ತಸ್ಮೈ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರವೇ ನಮಃ. Sheila, after having come out of experience that Mahasena has gone through, he moved only for one day in that world in a rock, which was created by the son of the Tangana Rishi. Now he had a direct experience of it. You can't say, I didn't have the experience. And when he came out, it was more than 12 million years. So the time scale inside that rock world was one day, and outside it became 12 million years. And therefore he was so much confused. I don't deny my experience. I had that experience. But how come outside it is so many years have passed, all my relations, everybody has died, and therefore he started crying. So the teacher, the Muniputra, now started telling him, see friends, unless there is something beyond our imagination happens, we do not begin any inquiry with sincerity. How it happened? If you take the lives of many great masters, suddenly something happens which we don't expect. Like the 8th November, as much all the citizens of our country are involved in discussing the same topic, no other topic. Now there is no issue of minority, there is no issue of reservation, there is no issue of rapes, there is no issue of Pakistan, no other issue. See? Because it was a common factor for all. All are united when it comes to money. Then there is no difference. In the same manner, when this king saw all that inside the rock and outside, so many millions of years have passed, therefore I have lost everything. See? All the money that I have collected, I have lost. Now what will I do with that 501,000? So, then we start crying. And then we justify. See? And the justification was, don't we see the people cry when they lose somebody, and I have lost everything, therefore I am crying. So he started justifying that what he is crying because of the loss is real, because everybody does that. Now, because everybody does something, that doesn't mean it is right. Yesterday also I told you, in case of the decision about the absolute reality, majority is not the law, majority's view is not the last word. No. See? For example, majority or all the people see the sky blue. Everybody sees the blue. Now, but the scientists, the physicists told us that it is an optical illusion. Should we say, do you think that all the people are fools? Any doubt? They are. This was not understood earlier in the Christian era. Therefore, that Socrates and all people were killed. Because how can you say that the earth is round and it is stable, it is moving around the sun. How can you say like that? The sun is moving. We can see every day. The sun comes and sun goes. Earth is so flat. How it is round? If you say that, you will be killed. See, friends. Therefore, when it is a topic of absolute reality, we must not vote for the majority. So, here the teacher tells, what you are justifying that you are miserable because of your nears and dears have died? Are your nears and dears only your parents or brothers? Are they not earlier than that? Did you cry for all the earlier generations? No. Therefore, here the teacher says, we become miserable only because we do not inquire. Normally, elderly people, they don't inquire, they only complain. The day we stop complaining, inquiry will begin. And the complaining is only because we are unable to interact in the light of wisdom. Because our thinking is how we have trained our mind to think. See, for example, be very attentive. When I was coming from the ISKCON temple, see, one type of people gather together for prayers, and the congregation is only talking about destruction and killing. The other place you go, they come together and talk only about guilt and fear. The third place you go, they'll be talking only, oh, the world is misery, misery. There is nothing other than the misery in this world. Therefore, renounce everything right from childhood and become a Babaji. See, friends. Now, these three types of trainings that are given to the humanity, they cannot break these barriers and go beyond. See, friends. Therefore, if we want to really know the truth, we have to correct our thinking process. And the thinking process is, without any biasness, we get into the logic or the reason. So here the logic or the reason given is, that all these people for whom we are crying that they have died, do we cry for everybody? No, we don't cry. But they all belong to our own family. Father, grandfather, great-grandfather. We don't even think about them. Forget about crying. Therefore, this is not a logic that you cry because your nears and dears have died. No logic. See? Then the second thing is, in this world, this is a story going on. Somebody is born, somebody dies. See, tasmat apariharethe natvam shochitum arharsi. Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita, when this is non-optional, you have to accept it. Do we cry that after the day, the night comes, after the night, the day comes? We don't cry, we accept it. There is no choice given to us. In this manner, when we start thinking, then we come to know that it is only because of erroneous thinking we are all miserable. And what is the erroneous thinking? The identity crisis as to who we are at a given period of time. Up to here, we have seen. Then, in this, the teacher also gave the examples of dream and waking. Dream is never experienced as a dream. During the dream, it is a solid reality. It is not a dream. Be attentive. In that dream, there is a dream event called as an accident. So if the dream is illusion, then the accident is also illusion. But because of that dream accident, only we come out of the dream. So during the dream, it was a solid reality. Exactly the same way, when we are living in this waking dream, everything appears to be a solid reality. So as the dream is beautiful, it never breaks. When an accident happens, it breaks. So also, this waking dream, when everything is goody-goody, 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 we don't think about anything except how lucky we are, how nice we are, we should give something to somebody. When I see poor people, I feel miserable. This goody-goody is not spirituality. About this, I'll tell you one thing. There is one very close family, and they are very successful. The parents are now retired, two sons. They are very well established in their own life. They have got one wife per head, two children, growing, healthy. Business-wise, they are spread all over the world. No bad habits, no nothing. Suddenly, one day, that lady asked me, Swamiji, you know everything is good in our life, but I always have a fear that kisi ki nazar na lag jaye. See? And because of that, in the prosperity, I am having some tinge of misery, fear, doubt. See, friends. Therefore, unless we start thinking properly, correctly, we will continue to be miserable. So as we don't get influenced by the dream, we will also not get influenced by the waking experiences, provided, number one, we are established in our essential nature. Number two, we play the role that we are supposed to play in the waking life. Whatever role we have to play, play the role beautifully. We don't have to justify anything. See? And in this manner, when we start leading, there will be everything happening, but there will be nobody born as, I am doing this, I am not doing this, I am sorry, I am justifying, I am trying to prove myself. This I will disappear. Like on the stage, an actor performs his role beautifully, perfectly, but an I is not born. See? This is the way. Therefore, the teacher tells, don't argue that a dream is temporary and it is not real. The dream hunger is satiated by the dream food. The dream enemy is killed by the dream weapons. The dream trees give the shadow to the dream people sitting below that. The dream birds are eating the dream fruits. Everything is real there. So there is no difference between the dream and the waking. Nobody's waking things are all the time firm. They are the same. They are not the same. We are not able to observe the changes. See? Therefore, when we start inquiring, we come to know this waking and the dream is one and the same. Therefore, there is no reason that one should become miserable. Svapna bhavaste na tulyo jagrat bhavopi sarvashaha. On this account of this discussion, therefore, waking and dream are equal. Yatha jagrati jagratvam gruhitam jagare sprutam, svapnepi jagratvam tu gruhitam tadvadevahi. This is what I told you now, concluding. As the dream is never experienced as a dream, but it is experienced as a solid reality, so also the waking dream is also experienced as a solid reality, but both of them have the same status. That is why, you know, one of the story which comes about Janak Maharaj. In the afternoon after the lunch, he was lying down below a tree in the royal garden. And in that short sleep, he had a dream. And in that dream, he saw there is a famine and everywhere there is big problem. He was hungry, And one rich man was distributing food, so he also went and stood in the queue. And after that, when his turn came to take the food, his roti was snatched away by a dog, and he was running and chasing the dog, and in that he fell down, and because of that he woke up, and he saw that he is still sleeping below the tree very comfortably. Then he asked this question. Now tell me, who am I? I, the beggar in the dream, is the real I? Or I, the waker, the king, is the real I? On the basis of that, Ashtavakra Gita is born. See, who is this I? You cannot deny the dream because you have experienced it. Similarly, you cannot deny the waking experiences that we are experiencing. So the one who is supporting both, waking as well as the dream, must be beyond the both. Like the one who is supporting the father and the son. So the one who is supporting the son is the man, with reference to his father. The same man also supports the father with reference to his son. So has this son or the father become real? Or the man is real? Think again and again. We all suffer only as the conditioned being, the aupadhik anekata. Because of the conditioning, we become many. There are not different Aadhaar cards for every personality. For a CEO, one Aadhaar card. For the husband, another Aadhaar card. For the father-in-law, no, one Aadhaar card. That Aadhaar is we, the reality. See, friends, therefore, evam sthite kuto rajan visheshaha svapna jagratoho tat svapna nijabandhustvam nahi shochati vaikutaha. Suppose in the dream you have seen that your brothers or somebody has died, there was a big accident and some terrorism has happened. When you see in the dream and when you wake up, do you cry for them? No. But during the dream, yes, you cry. Because that time it is real. When you awake out of the dream experience, you are no more miserable. Exactly the same way. Please recognize this. This is a waking dream. I'll tell you about what the impact of this is, if you take it in the right spirit. There was one man, and he was going very well with a girl. Not for a day or two, for almost maybe 5-10 years. But not married, going along very well. And one day that girl started going with some other man. And this person, who thought that she is very loyal to me, very sincere to me. One day she said, I am sorry, I don't have time for you. He became depressed, dejected so much that he called me. And he said, Swamiji, I want to talk to you. It was night 2:30. I said, okay, start talking, but I want to talk to you personally. I said, how can I talk to you personally? Where are you? I am standing outside your door. No, I can't say no to him. So he came. From 2:30 to 4:30, that Maharamayana has come out. And he was so miserable, crying, and a grown-up person, not a baby. So disturbed and disgusted. Then I told him something. And the conclusion of all what I told was this. My dear friend, all that has happened in your life with that girl was a beautiful dream. Now, the dream is broken. Awake. And it clicked him so quickly. He said, Swamiji, you have given me another life. I was thinking of finishing myself. See, friends, don't take any experience of life as a real one. Anything which comes and goes, like our satsanga, it is just a dream. And this satsanga is an accident in this waking dream. And from this accident, you will come out of this waking dream. See, this is not real, you are real. Come to discover this truth. But instead of that, we get lost objectively. See, like you know, some places you go in the ashram, they got beautiful things written. Love all, serve all. On the walls everywhere you will see this written. Love all, serve all. The walls love all and serve all, not the people there. See, friends. Therefore, my friends, we have to wake up from this waking dream. And when we wake up from our normal dream, we don't bother. We don't discuss. We are not proud. Do you know, in the dream, I was awarded doctorate. Or in the dream, you know, they disgusted way, they kicked me out of their house. No. Both are useless. And that is why the wise people, they do not talk about their past, good or bad. See, I told you one story, composition of the great saint Ramdas Swami, guru of Shivaji. He writes, by the grace of the guru, I have crossed the river of transmigration, Bhavanadi. And I was so happy. And therefore, to thank my guru and see the river that I crossed, I looked behind. Lo, there was neither the guru nor the river. I alone was. See, friends. But we get lost only in personalities, not in the principles. Everyone is our guru if we learn from them. Everyone. Don't tie down that principle of guru in a person. No. Bhagwan Dattatreya very clear details. He had 24 gurus. Why there is a poverty? Oh, ekich guru hai. This is Bombay type. Ekich guru. No. Simply talking, Ishavasya Vidam Sarvam, except that. Ishavasya Vidam Sarvam. No. Thus, break the barrier of individuality. When you are lost in individuality, you will see guru as an individual. But when you have broken the individuality and merge in the absolute, then everything, every being is our guru, provided we are able to learn from them. Therefore, sapne tu evam sthite kuto rajan visheshaha sapna jagrataha. Therefore, there is no difference between the waking and the dream. Tasmat tat svapna nijabandhunstvam nahi shoshachi vaikutaha. Therefore, you are not crying because the dream wife has died. You are not crying. Even the waking one dies, I will not cry, man. Don't worry. Kevalam bhavana matrat satyata jagati sthita shunyata bhavanena api shunyam nishpratigham bhavet. Now, this is the principle told now. After having told this whole analysis, kevalam bhavana matrat satyata jagati sthita. Now be attentive. It is only our bhavana that we imagine whatever we think is right, only by practice. See, this is how the people fall in love and then get up from the love. First they fall. That time the bhavana is, without her I cannot live, she is made for me, otherwise why she go on imagining and get married. And after that, then again the counter bhavana comes. I think I have done a mistake, but I must correct my mistake. It's only bhavana, nothing else. See, I'll tell you one example. There is one girl somewhere, and that girl wanted, when she was small, she wanted to become a cinema actress. And so much she was wanting, I want to become actress. But none of the qualities required for an actress are present in her. Not one. She doesn't know acting, she doesn't have good voice, she is not highly educated, she is not smart, she is not beautiful, none of them. But that has gone in her head. And then her father told, Swamiji, I don't know what to do with her. I said, don't worry, I'll take care. I was speaking to her. I said, since childhood, how many dramas you have participated in your school? No, Swamiji, not one. Good. Then, how many TV serials you have acted? Not one. Very good. So you have never done that. Then how come you suddenly want to become? I like it. Your liking has no meaning. See? Apni avkaat pehchano. And then I gave her some other thing. I said, look here, you have got this particular quality extraordinary in you. Why don't you explore that? And by God's grace, she recognized it. And today in that faculty, she has gone top. See, only imagination makes the thing real. The moment that imagination is destroyed, everything disappears. We have this bhavana, this world is real, this body is real. See, friends. It is so clear, this hall cannot be me, these clothes cannot be me, this body cannot be me, the mind cannot be me. Discard one by one. And we come to a point where there is experience, but it is not the experience of something. And because of that, an experiencer is not born. When this bhavana is practiced again and again and again and again. The earlier bhavana, that I am rich, I am poor, I am good, I am bad, I am lucky, I am unlucky, I have studied, I have not studied, I am healthy, everything will slowly start becoming erased. And we will lose obsessions in our life. There was one Westerner, young boy, he came to Nisargadatta Maharaj. And he came and sat there. So he was asked, why you have come here? He said, I don't know. No questions, no nothing. So when satsang was over, he heard everything. He said, are you likely to come tomorrow? He said, I don't know. And he went away. So other Kamandalus, they see, look at this boy. How is he doesn't know anything? Maharaj said, he is a far advanced than all of you put together. See, friends, when you start living your life with spontaneity, there is neither the burden of the past nor the worry of the future. When the past and the future are dropped, you have no option but to be the presence. This is our essential nature. Therefore, kevalam bhavana matrat satyata jagati sthita. This world becomes real only because of our bhavana and nothing else. So, shunyata bhavane napi shunyam nishpratigam bhavet. Therefore, now what is to be done? Now do the contrary bhavana. Contrary bhavana, you try this. I don't know what type of special spiritual practice you do. I tell you what I do. I do a lot of experiments on myself. Like one particular thing I used to like. I said, okay, let us try. I bought it many years before, must be about 30, 40 years before. I bought it, not little bit, 100 gram, 200 gram, 2 kilo. I sat in, keep it on the newspaper and ate the whole thing. Eat. After that, for 2-3 days, Madhya Pradesh was out of order. Burning all over the body. And thereafter, for next 1 month, I didn't eat at all. And then I found out, whether you eat or you do not, it makes no difference. You remain the same. When there was suffering, you are there. When there is no suffering, you are there. Slowly you come to know that our dependence on the things is only bhavana matra. Like Sindhis. Sindhis cannot think without papad. If somebody goes to their house, they may not give you water. Papad they will give. Havalelo. See. Go to Gujus. Gujus cannot think beyond dhokla. I will not be surprised if dhokla is described or declared as the national food. See. Was today, the PM is Guju. Then the BJP president is Gujju, then the person on the note, currency note is a Gujju, then the president or the director of the RBI is Gujju. See? Therefore, the whole country is doing Bhangra. Not Bhangra, Garbha. And therefore, why not make Dhokla as a national food? Don't get lost in this. It's only bhavana. Do the contrary bhavana. That I am none of them. Be attentive. Man, I am. Husband, I become. Man, I am. Happy, I become. Man, I am. Miserable I become. Whenever you become somebody, you have lost your originality. Spiritual practice is not becoming anything. It is unbecoming all what we have done. See? It is not gaining anything. It is losing everything. It is not becoming extraordinary. But it is discarding the extra that we have gathered around us. See, friends. Therefore, shunyata bhavane napi, when you discard these worldly things with understanding and wisdom, slowly their impact on us will disappear. And you will see this if you just analyze your own experiences of life in our childhood. How much we were interested in those small little games. That was all for us. Now, as we have grown up, now those things we don't hate, but we have grown out of them. Then we came in teenage. That time speed, motorcycle, car. Oh. And when we become old, speed is dropped. Then wisdom comes. Once one old man was driving me in South Africa. Open road, nice, no question of any road problem. He was driving I said, come on, go fast. He said, what is there to go fast? Even if you go fast, we will save maximum 5 minutes. Now to motivate him, I said, now what to do? I said, okay, let us play some game. Whichever car passes next to us, tell me the age of the driver. He said, Swami, you are always funny. How can I tell? I said, try something. One car pass. They tell the name of the age of the driver. I don't know. Somebody, you tell. I said, yes, I can tell. He was 26. How do you know? I said, let few go and then I'll tell you. Then another one went. And he was almost parallel. Sometime our car will go ahead, but he will remember again, come like that. I said, that man, you don't know, he must be 80. Then he asked ultimately, what is the way you are deciding it? I said, there is a rule. The rule is, the speed of the car is inversely proportionate to the age of the driver. See? When the driver is young, he will go, When an oldie like you is driving the car, it goes minus 40 per hour. And then the philosophy comes. So what was important, valuable, a challenge in the young age becomes redundant in the old age. Bhavana matra. See, friends, therefore, this bhavana, when we do contrary to our notions. So what is our bhavana? I am body. There we stop? No. I am lohana kachchi. There I stop. I am not a coal dealer. I am a diamond dealer. See? How many specialities we are attracted towards ourselves. Now do the contrary. And when you start contrary practice, the net result will be worldly things and beings will stop giving any impact on you. Things will happen around. But they will have no impact on us. Bhavana yapramanatve dhuryena sthirikruta tattat bhaveta atma bhavena satyametan mahipate. Therefore, because we have given a status of reality to this world, therefore this world has become real. Otherwise this world is not real. We have given importance. See, like you know, these days, these page three people, you know the page three people? They will be always talking about dieting and then organic food. I could never understand till date what is inorganic food. Food is always organic. There is nothing like inorganic food. But we take only organic food, you know. We buy from a special thing, you know. All the funny notions. And the whole life is lost in that. So, tattat bhava atma bhavena satyam etan mahipate. Therefore, this is the truth. Whatever we think, do the bhavana, that is what we think we are. So, one technique which I told you, spend every day as much, as many times as possible, maybe short periods. Wherever you are sitting, just try this. What it is like being other than the body. See? Your mind has become still. When we play this, I am not telling you, I am other than the body. No, I am telling you play what it is like being, therefore not becoming. Don't become a witness. This witness, drop it. It doesn't help. On the contrary, remain indifferent. Not become indifferent, remain indifferent. Becoming is reducing ourselves. Being is deleting the reduction. And this can happen only when you start playing what it is like being other than the body. I guarantee you, from within you, you will get complete guidance. Allow your divinity to reveal. Don't have to go anywhere, wherever you are. And don't struggle. I will do it for 1 hour. No, no sankalpa. In a day, 10 times, 5 times, 7 times, as it happens. But keep this, that this is our spiritual practice. And this you can do anywhere. Sitting on the commode, you can do it. Call it as commode yoga. See? Don't have to worry about anything. No, no, no. Without bath, I don't go to toilet. There are people so obsessed. I had a friend and he was extremely obsessed with certain things, and I knew that. He came to attend one of my retreat. He is also a Swami, and I knew his obsession. So I always like playing fun. Life is fun, not a serious thing. So when he was attending, I told my organizer, I said, hey, that Swami who has come, he is extremely good in Ramayana. He sings well, but don't tell him now anything. We were going for a picnic. I said, when we go to the picnic, you must be tired of hearing me all the time. So something light, music and bhajan and all that. So what you can do? Carry about 50 that Ramcharitmanas small books. And when we go there, and it will take time to prepare food and all that, so you request him, Swamiji, that Swamiji we have been always hearing, but we want to hear from you, and we like Ramayana, and I know you must be knowing Ramayana because you are from UP, so please tell us something from Ramayana. He said, look here, there are no books, you know, how can I tell you? No, no, book we have got, because we already planned. His rule was, unless he finishes his yoga, then thereafter toilet, thereafter taking bath, thereafter changing the clothes, thereafter putting all the marks on the forehead, then doing the japa, then only he will go for satsanga to conduct satsanga. I knew his rule. Here it was not possible. He became so frustrated. Who told you? He said, no, nobody has to tell us. We want it. And he found out some excuse and all that. He didn't do it. Afterwards he came, you must have told him. See, friends, don't be obsessed with anything in life. Duragraha is more damaging than the Shani Graha. People are condemning Shani, but Shani is the most beautiful Graha which turns the direction of your life. See? There are two Grahas which change the direction of our life. One Graha is Shani. The second Graha is Shadi. What is Shadi? It turns the direction. If you read the other way around, it becomes Disha. Disha is direction. The moment you get married, the Disha of your life changes from being happy to struggling to become happy. Relax, relax, relax. Don't take life too seriously. So, Nirdhanam Nirdarshanam Tatra Chedam Jagadeta Dushtamevate Imam Shailam Parikramya Yauhi Pashyava Samprati. Now if you want to appreciate my statement, now let us see. This is that rock in which you have come with me, and we have gone and experienced one day wherever we have gone. Outside we have come, it is 10, 12 million of years. Now come with me. Let us go around this rock. So, punaha praha mahasenam medhavi muninandanaha raja drushtesha shailaha pada gavyuti matrakaha. Gavyuti, pada gavyuti means 1/4 of gavyuti means 1 mile. So, the circumference of this is only 1 mile. Let us go around it. So, he went and took around drushta evasya garbhete lokaha suvitata sputaha. So we have just walked only 1 kilometer circumference. In this, within this place, we have seen millions and millions of worlds in one day. See? And thereafter, esha jagrutta du swapna satyo mithyatmako va. Now tell me, what you have experienced inside that rock with me in one day? And what you are experiencing outside the rock, which has already crossed 12,000 or 12 million years, tell me whether that was true or this is true. You experience both. See, friends. So, Shaila Loke Yad Dinaikam Tatra Dvadasha Arbudaha. What was equal to one day in that world in the rock is equal to 12 million years outside. Vatsaran swanubhutaste satya satya vivechaya. Now both the places you have experienced, isn't it? There we were there for only one day. Here you are for 12 million years. Now tell me, you have experienced both. Whether that is real or this is real. Now apply this principle in our life. We go through experiences, good and bad. In the dream, good and bad experiences. When we wake up, do we give value to that? Similarly, waking experience, very rich, very comfortable. Dream experience, most miserable, pathetic. So what is the truth? See, my friends, therefore, vivechanam nasya bhavet svapna yor bhinna yor iva. You do not compare the two different dreams. Both the dreams are dreams. Will you say, in one dream I was a king, therefore it was a good dream. Other dream I was a beggar, therefore it was a bad dream? No. Two dreams are not comparable. They are only dreams. So also, this waking dream and the dream, they are nothing but the same. Abhavyamanam chaitattu liyate kshanamatrata. The moment you drop the dream, it disappears. Be attentive. The moment we drop the waking world as in deep sleep, where the waking world goes? There the dream world goes. Both we have experience. And the most important principle is, if we do not experience something, it doesn't exist for us. What doesn't exist for me? I don't care. See, friends, because without I, nothing exists. If I is not there, you cannot be. If I is not there, he, she, it, they cannot be. This you and he, she, it, they, second person, third person, they are dependent on the first person. So everything is existing in me. Alas, this I, we do not inquire. And we get carried away only by the experiences. See? I tell you how we get carried away. Somebody sent me one WhatsApp. In that, one lady was torturing a child. I could not see it completely. I just saw for about 20 seconds or then I closed it. Because the torture in that video It was, somebody must have taken it, you know, either the CCTV footing or like that. It was so bad, I stopped it and I just wanted to lie down. Next, about half an hour, 45 minutes, I could not sleep. Because what I saw there, it was so real for me. It must have happened to somebody. But whenever we give importance to something as real, that clearly indicates our body identification has not disappeared. When it happens on the screen in a picture, we know it is a picture, we don't get disturbed. But those who do not understand it is just a picture, they get influenced by that movie, by that drama, and start becoming also miserable. Therefore, one has to again and again recognize this, that abhavyamanam chetattu liyate kshanamatratah. Therefore, when you stop giving importance and value to the worldly things and beings, they can no more influence you. Like the waves do not influence the ocean, like the oceans do not influence the waters. Tasmat shokam jahi nrupa aveksha swapna samam jagat. The conclusion of this theme is, therefore, hey nrupa, hey king, O Mahasena, aveksha jagat swapna samam. Look at the world only as a dream. Be attentive. Dream are only images. They are the food that we eat, also our mind. The one who is eating is also our mind. The one who likes the food is also our mind. The one who threw away the food is also the mind. So the mind alone, it has taken the position of everything, experienced, experiencer, and experiencer. All the three things are nothing but our mind. And what is the mind? Mind is nothing but a congregation of thoughts. And the thoughts are further divided into objectivity and subjectivity. And this is the dream experience. Now come to the waking experience. What we experience in the waking is also only the thoughts. See, friends. Today I was with a dentist. I was having a doubt whether I'll be able to speak or not. So till I came here, it was bleeding. So when I went to Krishna's temple, I said, kindly suck it up, okay? Enough. Now after going again, he'll start. So when he gave me injections here and there, and did a lot of, you know, caterpillar was brought, you know, and so when their anesthesia was given, no pain, no nothing. And after that effect of anesthesia is gone, now the pain has taken its own place. So instead of becoming miserable, learn. Every experience happens only in the mind. And when the mind gives this, that this is a good experience, bad experience, you suffer. See, friends. So the whole waking experience happens only in the mind. How? The world enters the mind through the sense organs. After the world enters the mind, it is only an image. It is only a thought. Therefore, whether it is a waking experience which is conducted by the mind, or it is a dream experience which is also conducted by the same mind, so one experience you say it is real, other you say it is an illusion. Is it the right way of thinking? Either accept the dream as real or delete the waking as real. Either write the autobiography of a dreamer or don't write the autobiography of a waker. See, friends. Therefore, Upanishad very clearly tells, Nayamatma balahine na labhyaha. Those who are not courageous enough to discard their individuality, they'll be all the time holding on to this notion that I am good, I do good to everybody. Who wants? Even if we don't do good, nobody requires us. But then we get entangled in this world. And as a result, we forget our own divine nature. See, friends. Therefore, tasmat shokam jahi nrupa. Therefore, my dear king, give up this misery that you are suffering by recognizing that this waking world is nothing but like another dream. Swapna chitram bhitti bhutam swatmanam samvidatmakam darpana prati samam matva samsthitosi yatha tatha. Then who are you? Then, like the mirror supporting all the reflections without getting influenced by any reflection, in the same manner, remain as the conscious substratum supporting the waking, the dream, the deep sleep, and the samadhi. When the waking reflection dream comes, nothing is added to the pure consciousness. When the dream comes, nothing is happening to the consciousness. When it is a deep sleep, nothing is lost from the consciousness. When it is a samadhi, whether it begins or ends, there is neither the beginning nor the end to this pure conscious mirror in which this world of jagra, sapna, sushupti and samadhi is just appearing. That is our essential nature. This is what Bhagavad Gita so distinctly tells. Sarvasya chaham hrudi sannivishtaha mattaha smriti jnanam apoharancha. I am the essence of everything. And in me alone, the waking, jnanam, smriti, the dream, apoharam, the deep sleep, chakarat, samadhi, all of these are happening in me. Like everything is reflected in the mirror. When the fire is reflected, it doesn't burn the mirror. When the water is reflected, it doesn't wet the mirror. Think, friends, when the vehicles move in the mirror as reflection, they don't leave any marks on the mirror. Is it not true? Waking has come and gone so many times. We claim I am grown up. It is the body that is growing up. We never have the experience that we are growing up. That mirror, the samvit darpana, the conscious mirror in which everything is just happening. Will the mirror ever say, when a beautiful girl is standing in front of, hey dear, kindly hang around a little longer, I like you? No. If you only like me, goes and stands before the mirror, will the mirror say, come on, get out, enough, next one? No. Is it not equally true? Our own experience. Waking comes, goes. Dream comes, goes. Deep sleep comes, goes. Samadhi begins, ends. We are the same. See, the word, we are the same. We don't become the same. We are talking about being, not becoming divine. You are not taking moj karo, moj me raho. Discover this truth. It is for this purpose such beautiful stories were told. But what happens? Stories we remember, the truth we forget. So, darpana pratimam matva samsthitosi yatha tatha jagat chitra darpanam cha aveya atmanam chidatmakam paramanandita svantaha bhava shigram mahipate. Therefore, O dear king, recognize yourself to be the mirror in which this reflection of the world is appearing. There are more questions which will come out of this. Now those questions become the next chapter, that is the 14th chapter. We'll try to see whatever we can see it tomorrow. Jagat chitra darpanam cha avyeya atmanam chidatmakam paramanandita svantaha bhava shigram mahipate. Therefore, you are the darpana, not the reflected or the reflection. With this, the 14th chapter begins now. Ityakarna munivachaha vicharya shubhayadhiya jagasthitim swapnasamam jnatva shokam jahodrutam dhairyamalambya nishoko bhuyo pruchen munesatam muniputra mahabuddhe tvam paravara darshanaha tatopya viditam kinchit manne syaditi leshataha pruchami yadaham tanme kripaya vaktumahasi. Having thus heard from the great teacher, the muniputra, then vicharya shubhaya dhiya, be attentive. Then he reflected with a positive, creative, unbiased analysis of our own experiences. See each and every word. Vicharya shubhaya dhiya. It is okay during the satsang, the lecturer is a Brahman, and after the lecture, Brahma. During the lecture, tyagi nahi ki amrutatva maharashu. After the lecture, paisa nikalo. See, friends, therefore, it has to be sincerely, clearly, up to the bone marrow. Jagasthiti swapna samamatnyatva shokam jahodhrutam. Therefore, whether you study Gita or Vedanta, you lose your right to be miserable. You cannot justify that you are miserable. Shokam jahau drutam dhairyam alambya nishokaha bhuya apruchan munesutam. Then he again gathered his wits and again he asked the son of the great Muni, hey Muniputra, hey Mahabuddhi, O the wise one who knows both the manifest and the unmanifest reality, although you told me, I have clearly understood, yet kinchin me syaditi leshataha, I have something still hanging on in my mind, little bit. Can you please help me to get out of it? Pruchami yadaham tanme krupaya vaktumarasi. Will you please tell me? And then he says, bhavana prabhavam hetat sarvam vadami tat katham maya bhuyo bhavite cha nahi bahi sarvata bhavet. You told everything is bhavana, only thinking. It's okay what you said, but I am not able to digest it because in this, outside we do the bhavana is different, inside we do the bhavana is different. How it can be same? Tvayatu bhavana siddhya shaila loka prakalpita. By only bhavana, you created the world outside. And athapi desha kalascha yugapad vidvidham katham. So if your mind only created the whole world, there it was one day time scale, and the same mind you are talking to me outside, it has already crossed 12 million years. How the same mind is thinking on two time scales? On one time scale, your mind is creating the world. On another time scale, it is the other solid world. How to digest this? This is very difficult for me. Tatra asatyamanyat itarat katamam tan maya iritam iti prushto munisutaha pravoktum upachakrame. So, between the two, one must be unreal. Therefore, kindly tell me, what is the reality behind this bhavana, the sankalpa that you are emphasizing so much? And iti prushto manisudaha pravaktum upachakrame, in reply to this question, now the Muni Sutta, the son of that Tangarang Rishi, he now starts explaining what is the meaning of sankalpa, what is the meaning of bhavana, and because of which, how different time scales are produced, how different things are produced, how the concept of in and out is created, and how they are real or unreal. This is a very subtle, deep topic. Tomorrow, concluding session, we'll see whatever we can see. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachate Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.